In this video, I'm going to show you a 3D Mohr circle using Monte Carlo simulation with stress transformation. Basically, if we have a stress tensor and a direct cosine matrix N about new axis, then stress tensor in new axis will be N times all the stress tensor times transpose N. If we have a diagonal stress tensor that is a principal stress, then we can produce new stress tensor will be a 3D Mohr circle. Well, let's drive stress transformation first. Okay. If we have a surface with a normal factor n, then we have column matrix for traction vector, and we have Lie matrix cosine, direct cosine matrix. And sigma nn means the normal stress, and sigma ns means shear stress. Then we can express normal stress and shear stress like this way. The Lie matrix of the DGN multiplied by column matrix of traction vector. So in general, if we have n vector surface and I direction component will be expressed this way. And as we know, the traction vector will be expressed stress tensor times normal vector n. Then sigma nn, sigma ns1, and sigma ns2 column matrix will be direct cosine matrix times stress tensor times normal vector n. So stress tensor in new axis will be combination of stress vector, right? Then it will be expressed in this way. Direct cosine matrix times stress tensor, the old stress tensor, right? And M vector is the first column, then second column, and third column. This will be the column matrix. And this one is actually transpose of direct cosine matrix. So new stress tensor will be direct cosine matrix n times the old stress tensor times transpose m matrix. Okay, then we are ready to how to produce the 3D Mohr circle using this equation. Instead of using this equation, I just break down the direct cosine matrix with simple rotation. First, new axis will be sequence rotation of simple rotation x and simple rotation y and then simple rotation z. Then based on this equation, new stress tensor in new axis will be n times sigma times transpose n, and that one will be again transformed by n times old stress tensor times transpose n. Again, this one will be another old stress tensor. So finally, new tensor will be M matrix times old stress tensor times transpose n. I just break down the direct cosine matrix because it's easy to build a Monte Carlo simulation with the Python code, because simple rotation matrix will be this way, very simple. Then we can just produce angles theta using a uniformly distributed random number. Okay, let's look at the Python code briefly. Let's try 300 number Monte Carlo simulation, and if we have the old stress tensor and simple rotation angle A about X, about Y, and about the Z axis, then rotation matrix will be this way. Instead of direct cosine matrix, I just using simple rotation matrix. That means I have to use the opposite sine theta A. Same way, rotation matrix about B, rotation matrix about G direction. Then final rotation matrix will be C times B times A. And new stress tensor will be rotation matrix transpose times stress tensor times rotation matrix. If we use direct cosine matrix, then this will be M matrix times S old times M matrix transpose. Then S new stress tensor will have normal vector and two components of shear stress. So I just calculate normal stress and resultant normal stress. Normal stress, resultant normal stress, normal stress, and resultant normal stress. I just used uniformly distributed random number, so random.rand. Initial old stress tensor will be a principal stress. Then we are ready to create the animation graph. Plus subplot and X data and Y data. For the first normal and shear stress, I just use red circle. The second normal and shear stress, I just use blue circle. During Monte Carlo simulation, I just update iteration number, initial state, at each frame, at each calculation, we just calculate new stress tensor and plot the normal and shear stress, normal and shear stress, normal and shear stress, update frame number, iteration number. Finally, we define the animation function. Okay, let's run the Python code. Yeah. Okay, it's done. And with arbitrary sequence simple rotation, we produce a black dot, red dot, and blue dot in three. Initially, we have sigma 1 and sigma 2 and sigma 3. And using stress transformation in 3D, in Monte Carlo simulation, we produce random simple rotation about X and Y and Z, and we got the normal stress and resultant shear stress. Thank you for watching this video.